The world of Cyberpunk 2077 is a retro-futuristic dystopian sci-fi nightmare where mankind, through its obsession with power, glamour and body modification, has blended itself so seamlessly with technology that the line between myth and machine is no longer clear. Advanced cybernetics allow us to upgrade our bodies with everything from rejection-proof artificial organs to enhanced optical replacements. In this world, existence is broken and divided between those that have everything, those who have nothing, and Keanu Reeves. The United States is no more. Balkanized and bankrupted by wars, orbital strikes, famine, and rebellions turned it into an economic collapse. Into the vacuum, the government rushed the mega corporations, building walled enclaves of gleaming steel and concrete guarded by elite security forces. Behind those walls live those lucky enough to work for the corporations. Outside those walls, chaos reigns. The heartland of America, also known as the Badlands, is now a dust bowl where caste, nomad families travel from place to place in huge packs. RVs, campers, motorcycles, cars, vans, constantly moving, surviving any way they can. In space, the orbitals, controlled by the Eurozone countries, keep their mass drivers pointed at the Earth, ready to unleash cheap destruction, pelting anyone who challenged their economic sovereignty with rocks mined from the asteroid belt. In the old cities, the remains of local and state governments struggle to hold at bay the forces of lawlessness. Gangs of every stripe and flavor flourish, fighting constantly for control of territory. Here, the corporations deal in a wide range of areas, such as weapons, robotics, cybernetics, pharmaceuticals, communication, and biotechnology. We're set in Night City, located in California, just south of San Francisco. It's a megalopolis, filled with a wide array of people that reside in one of six districts. The city center, Santo Domingo, Pacifica, Watson, Haywood, and Westbrook. The city center is the central hub of Night City and the heart of the corporations that control it. Expect luxury apartments, rich citizens, and the hum of neon signage. Santo Domingo is the district that powers the entire metropolis, an industrial zone stuffed with factories, power plants, and generators. Don't wander into Pacifica unprepared. This is where the seedy underbelly of Night City operates in the open. Pacifica is overrun by gangs and full of trouble. Watson, on the other hand, is a maze of marketplaces, cramped streets, and a bustling street life. This is the district where the Asian community congregates. The Latino district of Night City, Haywood, is where your adventure begins, acting as your first hub. You live in an apartment here, mingled in among the gangs, the corps, and the other factions of Night City. If you don't know Westbrook, you can't afford it. Westbrook is home to the rich and the famous of Night City, filled with social spaces, expensive eateries, and with a busy nightlife. Scattered among these districts, different people make up the population. Entropism, kitsch, neo-militarism, and neo-kitsch make up the style of the general population. Entropism, the look of poverty that derives from humans grappling and struggling against technology and its unforgiving advance. It denotes a lack of design blending with the general poverty of means and ideas. Kitsch, the look of a long-lost golden age on people entirely unwilling or unable to forget. It's flashy, bold, and usually cheap, filled with gold-plated cyberware, implants encased in brightly colored plastic, and larger-than-life makeup. Neo-militarism, being the opposite of kitsch, is the look of global conflict and corporations jockeying for power. Cold, sharp, and modern, making everyone look as if they are ready to drop out an AV's cargo door and head straight into combat. Neo-kitsch, the look of infinite wealth and vanity. Synonymous with luxury, it's been blossoming among Night City's wealthiest elites. Those who can afford to buy anything, who can afford to be anything they want to be. The city is full of possibilities, but those don't come without its risks. The dangers of Night City present themselves in the form of the many factions. Corporations, nomads, gangs, cops, and edge runners. In the late 21st century, with the government of the world increasingly weakened by conflict and wealth disparity, corporations have stepped into the breach to provide those with education, intelligence, and the means to live a safe and protected existence. Soldiers, either employed by the corporation or rented from another, patrol the streets and buildings of the enclaves and keep its citizens safe. Surveillance is everywhere, crimes are rare and ruthlessly punished. Corporate citizens believe themselves truly free, having sacrificed all liberty for the sake of security. Across the dust bowls and empty highways of Middle America roam the fast nomad packs. Families, clusters of different families, sometimes entire towns, left to dry up by climate change, corporate greed and neglect, have taken to roam the country, looking for places to call home. Most nomad families maintain strict moral codes and obey the old laws of the land, though of course there are always some dark, twisted exceptions. Members of a nomad pack can always call on family to defend them, though loyalty within the family is fierce and unquestioning. It is the only way they have survived. Like the rats with whom they share the dark parts of the city, gangs are everywhere and nowhere at the same time. Traditional gangs who trade in drugs and guns are still common, but in this age of cheap, readily available cybernetic enhancements, a new and fearsome group, the Booster Gangs, have established a heavy presence in the disputed streets of the cities. Boosters are addicted to cybernetic enhancements and exist only to find the next Chrome upgrades, by whatever means necessary. Despite the fall of the federal government, some towns and cities still maintain a semblance of municipal integrity, and the concept of law and order is not forgotten, even amongst the chaos of 2077. The fight to take the streets back block by block from gangs goes on every day and takes a heavy toll on those who live and breathe the fight on behalf of justice for those too poor to live in enclaves and too weak to run the edge. And that's exactly where we come in. Street samurai, soldiers of fortune, mercenaries or lone wolves. Whatever you want to call them, the edge runner exists in the margins. They take the jobs too risky for anyone else. They act as shadow agents for those who would not risk open war. They live for the money, owe nobody their loyalty, and live and die by their wits and skills. That's us. As everyone in the city, we're equipped with cybernetic enhancements. We can customize our runner cyberware, skill set and playstyle depending on the runner we select. We can choose from the following 8. Solos, techies, fixers, cops, medias, rockers, corps and netrunners. Solos live behind the trigger of a rifle. Maybe you spent time as a merc overseas, fighting in jungles for big pharma. Or walked the perimeter on a corporate enclave, constantly beset by booster gangs. Maybe you just picked up a rifle one day and decided you weren't going to take anyone's shit anymore. Either way, you're the one they call when the shit really goes down. You've got an extra edge in combat because you've survived this long. You know how to handle a rifle, a pistol, a saw, a grenade launcher, a 50mm chain gun, and you probably can work out how to set up a tech nuke if you have to. Just make sure you've got some stim packs handy, or better yet, a trauma team card. You're the one that fixes stuff when it breaks, or breaks into stuff that's locked, or locks stuff that needs to be guarded. Whatever the case, if it's got an electronic circuit, requires tools, or is just plain complicated, you're the one for the job. You might specialize in weapons, cybertech, or electronic security, which you can build, dismantle, fix, and sabotage basically anything made by anyone. Your cousin, the mad techie, can do everything you can, but just with a human body. Human bodies. You know a guy. Seriously. You probably know a lot of them. If it's on the street, underground, or anywhere it shouldn't be, you can get your hands on it. Blackmail info on a local union hat? No problem. Specs on the gang leader's hideout? Give me a real challenge. A crate of top-of-the-line Arasaka M66 automatic rifle in .223 caseless? Already got him. You are the law. And what the law says goes. Maybe you're a stiff-necked, by-the-book desk lieutenant. Maybe you're a hardened, street-smart sergeant who knows when to look the other way for the greater good. Either way, you wear the uniform and carry the boomstick, and those gangers better run when they see you coming. Maybe you get real lucky and catch a promotion to the Psycho Squad, the ones they call when a booster ganger installs one too many implants and goes on a cyberpsychosis rampage. Those are fun. In the information age, those who report the story control the story, and you're determined to be the first on the scene to do so. You've got a satellite uplink clipped to your belt, wired into a camera in your hat. No need for any clunky equipment or a tech team. Maybe you're a hungry stringer, making ends meet by selling your stories each night, determined to keep the truth sacred. Or maybe you're a veteran field eye for Network 54, selling the truth as the corps see it to delude the masses. Whatever the case, you're the eyes and ears of the world out there on the street. In these troubled times, you bet your ass that people are looking for someone to believe in. Someone whose message of hope and rebellion against a faceless, greedy corpse gives people a reason to go on struggling every day. You're a warrior poet, ready to put your life on the line to get the message out there, to keep the music alive, to make sure that people know that there are things worth fighting for. Your suit is worth more than most people's homes. You drive next year's model before it hits the lots. Your implants are tasteful and discreet, and your plastic surgeon is the best money can buy. But you're always looking for that leg up, that advantage in the next deal, and you're not shy about getting your hands dirty and hiring some outside muscle on the sly. The tech you've got in your head is beyond anything that most people can even fathom. Forget knowing programming languages, you've been reading them all since you were 5 years old. With your neural connection and your cyber modem, you directly interface with the net. Real-time computer users might as well be frozen in place. You're into the data fortress and back out again before they can even blink. And you left behind a crypto bomb just to let them know they've been hacked. If it's on a computer, you can get it and nobody can stop you. Running the edge is dangerous. Most don't live to see 30. You learn not to make friends because you'll probably be pulling their bodies out of a smoking rack. You stay frosty, stay hard, above all, you stay free. Whatever edge runner you decide to be, you will play as V. We get to choose from one of three origin stories, better known as life paths. We can be a nomad, corpo, or street kid. Each of the life paths has a different starting location and story background that are strongly connected. We'll be helped by none other than a man with the silver hand. A hallucination of sorts. Johnny Silverhand is the byproduct of a faulty chip in V's head, central to a mystery we have yet to hear about. Together, or alone, whatever you want to call it, we're going after that one-of-a-kind implant that is the key to immortality. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the Intel Brief, I would like to ask you to like or dislike, share, subscribe, and click the notification bell to become part of the Masterminds HD community and notification squad. On top of that, you can follow me on Twitter or Instagram for daily updates and behind-the-scenes posts. Join my Discord if you're looking for a rising community that revolves around Cyberpunk 2077. Both links are in the description. Visit my Patreon page through the link in the description if you're interested in the intel briefs on the factions, characters and events with the summarized information from these videos. To end the video, I have a question for you. Are you planning on playing Cyberpunk 2077? Leave your answer in the comment section down below and I'll make sure to get back to you. I'll talk to you in the next video on Discord, Instagram, Twitter or on YouTube. Peace out.